I'm ready. I'm ready. You know, I guess every character's voice morphs and changes over the...
Yeah, I think he was a little more down here when he started. Maybe because he was a little more in the grown-up world. And, sort of working at the, working at the restaurant and stuff. And then, sort of without us noticing, his voice kind of, as he became more childlike in the scripts and as he became more of a kid in some of the stories.
He just sort of went, there was only so much that you could do in this range down here. Wow, Gary. And then he started getting more excited and more up here and just like, whoa, and so I think he just became more hyperactive, more child, and I think I felt like I needed some place to go where I have more wiggle room, as his character developed, as he got more layers.
It doesn't seem right, but it feels so good.
You don't even really notice it, nobody notices it. It's just sort of like erosion, it's just kind of slow process, positive erosion.
Oh, okay, so let's see. Sometimes you gotta reverse engineer this stuff. You go, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready. Okay, so let's give him a call. He's got the suds. I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready.
Oh, I better turn my mic down for this.
I have been wanting to say this for a long, long time. I'm ready.
Oh, cool.
I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready.
That stuff is so... You guys are weird. Oh, so like a Valley Girl SpongeBob.
Hello. I'm ready.
Great. Wow. Let's see. So a pro wrestler would say, I'm ready. But SpongeBob will,
I'm ready.
Well, there's a lot, And what I love about SpongeBob is that like once one of those catchphrases becomes kind of iconic, they are sort of reticent to reuse it. Even I'm ready, it doesn't get overused. It's a, I'm ready! He'll say it here and there, but that was kind of like the first words he uttered, when he slammed out of his pineapple in that pilot.
I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready.
It's funny, the ones that people ask for are sometimes surprising. They'll come up to you at a Comic-Con and they'll just go, my sister's favorite line is, are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
I'm feeling a warm spot.
Sorry.
That's her favorite line? And they go, yeah, So, there's a lot of them, Could you say he was number one?
It was his hat, Mr. Krabs. He was number one.
It's like, wow, that's 20 seasons. That's your favorite line? And they're like, yeah, I love that. Yeah, there's so many.
You like Krabby Patties, don't you, Squidward?
Do I have a favorite? There's a Patchy line. This is a really obscure one. But Patchy the Pirate in one of the earlier appearances, Potty the Parrot, the marionette parrot, is bugging him. And he just looks at him and goes, you, I'm ignoring.
Man overboard?
You, I'm ignoring.
So it's funny, I've never heard anyone else love that line, but I use that one a lot, Still, with my kids when they're bugging me, you, I'm ignoring, And it just comes in handy. It's like Borscht Belt Pirate, you, I'm ignoring.
That's right, Potty.
So if I could make a line more iconic than it is, it would be, you, I'm ignoring. I just found that line so funny, and I've never found anybody else who even remembers it, It's like, well, I liked it. You know, sometimes when you're talking to kids, you know, because they're like, generally, no. But I know, like, when I'm reading stuff, like, these are scripts that I'm dealing with right now. So a lot of times when I'm reading the script, I won't know my kids are behind me. They're like, Dad, you're talking out loud, you know. But like, quiet. Like, I'm talking to, like, a crazy guy on a bus. You're just kind of reading in everybody's voice. They're like, Dad, you're doing it again. It's like, I have to hear it that way. But a lot of times, yeah, most of the time I won't do it unconsciously, like slip into it. But kids want to hear it, you know, especially kids, you know, and 20, when I say kids, I mean 20 somethings. I mean, everybody from like 4-year-olds up to like 34-year-olds. So that's that's true. Yeah. Wow. 100% impacted my life in unforeseen ways, you know, being the vocal component of this thing that makes people happy, makes them laugh. Yeah. You know, they associate it with positive things in their life, you know, people that they watched it with. So that kind of stuff is really impactful to me. Like just to be the connective, a little part of that connective tissue, just to be one cell in that organism. Like, you know, I think the biggest movie stars might not ever get to feel that.
We're having so much fun. Doesn't that make us winners?
Thanks for watching.